الحمد لله رب العالمين له الحمد الحسن والثناء الجميل وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له يقول الحق وهو يهدي السبيل وأشهد أن سيدنا ونبينا محمد صلى الله عليه وعلى آله وأصحابه والتابعين لهم بإحسان إلى يوم الدين أما بعد. I was reading a hadith Al-Imam Ahmad narrated in his Musnad and other than Imam Ahmad rahimahullah. And this hadith is sahih thabit. It's authentic and it has been transmitted from the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. And it's a hadith narrated by the noble companion Abdullah ibn Busr al-Mazini radiyallahu ta'ala anhu. He's the narrator of the hadith. He mentions anna rajulan ata an-nabiyya sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. A man came to the Prophet عليه الصلاة والسلام. And this man said to the Prophet, إِنَّ شَرَائِعَ الْإِسْلَامِ قَدْ كَثُرَتْ. That the legislations of Al-Islam has become too much. The Sharia and the rulings pertaining to the religion and the Ahkam have now become a lot. Because in Mecca, the Ahkam were very little. The things that you could do, or the things that were needed from you, were little. And the things that you had to stay away from in Mecca were little. But then when the companions moved to Medina, there came more ahkam because there came down more verses in the Quran. So this man said to the Prophet عليه الصلاة والسلام, إِنَّ شَرَائِعَ الْإِسْلَامِ, the rulings of Al-Islam, قَدْ كَثُرَتْ, it has become a lot on me, علينا, on all of us. He said to him, فَبَابٌ نَتَمَسَّكُ بِهِ جَامِعٌ. He said to the Prophet of Allah, give us something we can hold on to. Something that's comprehensive, jami'. And we all have to ponder here. This man is saying to the Prophet of Allah, Inna shara'i' al-Islami qad kathurat. The ahkam is too much. And the reason why I believe this hadith should be of today's reflection is because many of us have responsibilities. We have duties. We've got work. We wake up. Our time has been preoccupied with so much duties and so many things that we need to do. So this question of this companion, many of us will fall under it. Isn't that the case? So the Prophet of Allah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam is now going to tell him what he believes to be the most comprehensive thing that he should come with and that he should hold on to. The Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he said to him, لَا يَزَالُ لِسَانُكَ. Your tongue, in the Arabic language, the la is a nafi. And yazalu has ma'na nafi, has a meaning of negation in it. And the qa'idah in the Arabic language is nafi, nafi, ithbat. Negation, negation is affirmation, even in English. If you negate twice, it becomes an affirmation. So here the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam is trying to say, فَلْيَقُلْ لِسَانُكَ, let your tongue be. رَطْبًا مِنْ ذِكْرِ اللَّهِ, moist in the remembrance of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And then this is the answer of the Prophet. Be a person whom every opportunity, every moment, every time, your tongue is remembering Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So for the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, this is a babul jami'. According to the Prophet now, because that was what he was asked for. A very comprehensive thing that a person can hold on to. And the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, what did he tell him? He told him to increase in the remembrance of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Why is this jami'? The reason is because number one, Ibn al-Qayyim mentions, is because it's very easy for the person to do. Actions of the limbs, they may require a lot of effort from you. To pray salah, it requires effort from you. More than just sitting somewhere and your tongue saying words that are light. That's why the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he said in the hadith, kalimatani, two words. What are they? Khafifatani. They are very light. Those two words are very, very light. And what are they light on? على اللسان, they are light on the tongue. ثقيلتان, but they are very heavy. في الميزان, on the scale of the day of judgment. The person can say it. He's driving a car, he's a taxi Uber driver, he can do his dhikr. He can say these two words. A person is a pilot, he can do it. A person is picking up their shopping, they can do it. A person is at work, giving tickets to people. Whatever the job and the role that you are holding, you can still be doing your dhikr. You can be working in a warehouse, you can still be doing dhikr. That's why the Prophet ﷺ here is saying, kalimatani, two words, are what? Khafifatani ala lisani. They are very light on the tongue. And they are what? Saqilatani fil mizani. But on the scale of the Day of Judgment, it is what? It is very heavy. And from this hadith, some of the ulama, they took that things may appear sometimes to be something, but they are not necessarily like that the Day of Judgment. These words are very easy to say. People would think, because it's easy to say it, the reward is also going to be easy. It's going to be very small reward. But the reality is that the reward is great. The Prophet told us in a famous hadith, إِنَّ اللَّهَ لَا يَنْظُرُ إِلَىٰ أَجْسَامِكُمْ وَلَا إِلَىٰ صُوَرِكُمْ. Allah does not look at a person's form. Allah does not look at a person's image. But what does Allah look at? وَلَكِ يَنْظُرُ إِلَىٰ قُلُوبِكُمْ أَعْمَالِكُمْ. Allah looks at the person's heart and Allah looks at the person's actions. The Prophet told us in another hadith, يُؤْتَى, it will be brought the Day of Judgment. رَجُلٌ بَدِينٌ سَمِينٌ. A man who is, he's weighty, he's heavy. And he's big. فَيُوضَعُ فِي الْمِيزَانِ, he will be placed on the scale. فَلَا يَزِنُ عِنْدَ اللَّهِ جَنَحَ بَعُوضَهِ. And he doesn't weigh up a wing of a mosquito. So some things in this world, they look like in a particular way. But this man who's big on the scale, he should be heavy, right? Huh? Should he not be? But he's not heavy. It's because it's bigger than the weight on him. And the same is with this you're saying. It's very light on the tongue. What is it that the person says? Subhanallah wa bihamdi, Subhanallah al-Azim. The Prophet told us that these are two heavy words on the scale. But they are very light on the tongue. That's the first reason why the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam mentioned this to be jami', comprehensive. The second reason is because the fawaid that I'm going to now mention, all of these benefits that I'm going to mention that fall under it, are all the reason why it's comprehensive. I'm going to mention A, B, C, so much benefits that the remembrance of Allah holds. But what I want you to all remember, brothers, is I gathered this from the Kitab Al-Wabil Al-Sayyib. Al-Wabil Al-Sayyib, written by, does anyone here know who wrote it? Al-Wabil Al-Sayyib? Does anyone know who wrote that book?
Ibn al-Qayyim.
Ibn al-Qayyim wrote it. Does anyone know what Wabil Al-Sayyib means? The word Wabil and Al-Sayyib? Does anyone know what it means? Al-Wabil and Al-Sayyib? Huh? It basically means rain that benefits. It's the matar when it comes down and it benefits the people. It's not the matar that kills the people. Ibn al-Qayyim's hikmah and the way he looked at it was that the dhikr is like what? It's like the water. When it comes down, it gives life to the earth. Where did Ibn al-Qayyim get that from? Didn't Allah say in the Quran, أَلَمْ يَأْنِنِ الَّذِينَ آمَنُوا أَن تَخْشَعَ قُلُوبُهُمْ لِذِكْرِ اللَّهِ وَمَا نَزَلَ مِنَ الْحَقِّ وَلَا يَكُونُوا كَالَّذِينَ أُوتُوا الْكِتَابَ مِنْ قَبْلُ فَطَالَ عَلَيْهِمُ الْأَمَدُ فَقَسَتْ قُلُوبُهُمْ وَكَثِيرٌ مِنْهُمْ فَاسِقُونَ. What did Allah say after that? اعلموا أن اعلموا أن الله يحيي الأرض بعد موتها. Why is Allah mentioning giving life to this earth after it died? The same way that when that rain comes down, it gives life to the earth, is فَطَالَ عَلَيْهِمُ الْأَمَدُ فَقَسَتْ قُلُوبُهُمْ. That these people, when they left the remembrance of Allah, ألم يأن للذين آمنوا تخشع قلوبهم لذكر الله وما نزل من الحق. There's a relationship between that rain coming down and giving life to this earth, is that the dhikr, when it comes, what does it give to the heart? It gives it life. So Ibn Qayyim saw that it was appropriate to call the book Al-Wabil Sayyid, rahimahullah. And those are the fawaid. In that book of his, Ibn Qayyim, he mentions close to 100 benefits of dhikr of Allah, remembering Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So inshaAllah ta'ala, I'm going to mention some of the benefits that are in the remembrance of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. The first benefit inshaAllah ta'ala is, of course, it gives life to the individual, which we just mentioned now. The remembrance of Allah, it gives life to the what? It gives life to the heart. Just like your body needs carbohydrates, it needs protein, it needs vitamin, the heart needs the remembrance of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. ولذلك the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said in the hadith, which is in Sahih Bukhari and Muslim, مثل الذي يذكر ربه, the example of the one who remembers his Lord, والذي لا يذكر ربه, and the one who doesn't remember his Lord, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, is like مثل الحي والميت, is like one who is alive and one who is dead. That's the difference between the two. And in another wording, the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he said, مثل البيت الذي, the example of a house, الذي يذكر فيه, the house which it's remembered in it, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, والبيت الذي لا يذكر فيه, and the house which is not mentioned in Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, is again like مثل الحي والميت. لذلك that's what Allah said in the Quran, وَمَنْ يَعْشُ عَنْ ذِكْرِ الرَّحْمَانِ نُقَيِّضْ لَهُ شَيْطَانًا فَهُوَ لَهُ قَرِينٌ. Does anyone know what the word وَمَنْ يَعْشُ, what does the word يَعْشُ mean? The floor is open. What is the word يَعْشُ, وَمَنْ يَعْشُ عَنْ ذِكْرِ الرَّحْمَانِ, what does it mean? أي معنى غفلة. Anyone who is heedless, وَمَنْ يَعْشُ عَنْ ذِكْرِ الرَّحْمَانِ, anyone who is heedless from what? The remembrance of Allah. Who's going to take him as a qareen? Who's going to take him as a close friend? Because the qareen is somebody who doesn't leave you, right? So the shaytan becomes your mulazim. Shaytan is always with you. Sah? And then now the person comes up to you when they are sick now, their iman is 100% gone down. This person is truly suffering. Huh? But why did they start to suffer? Every day. They just kept remembering Allah. Whenever they did something, they just done their adhkar, they did their remembrance of Allah, their heart would have been alive. وَلِذَلِكَ شَيْخُ الْإِسْلَامِ ابْنُ تَيْمِيَةَ, he said, الذِّكْرُ لِلْقَلْبِ, that the remembrance is for the heart, said like what? مِثْلُ الْمَاءِ لِلْسَمَكِ, just like the water, وَعَلَيْكُمُ السَّلَامِ, the fish is for the water, right? Ibn al-Taymiyyah, they say, فَكَيْفَ يَكُونُ حَالُ السَّمَكِ, what will the situation of the fish be إِذَا فَارَقَ الْمَاءِ, if he leaves the water? Think about that. If you take a fish out of the water, what will happen to him? If you take a believer out of the remembrance of Allah, or a person out of the remembrance of Allah, what will happen to him? The person will, he will die. فلذلك in the Quran, that's why a lot of the places you see, Allah refers to as life. Look what he says. يا أيها الذين آمنوا استجيبوا لله وللرسول إذا دعاكم لما يحييكم, that which is going to give you life. What is it that he's going to call you to? Is the remembrance of Allah. What did Allah say? أتى أمر الله فلا تستعجلوه سبحانه وتعالى عما يشركون ينزل الملائكة بالروح. Allah is referring us. What is Allah referring the Quran as what? الروح. In another ayah, what does he say? وَكَذَلِكَ أَوْحَيْنَا إِلَيْكَ رُوحًا مِنْ أَمْرِنَا مَا كُنْتَ تَدْرِي مَا الْكِتَابُ وَلَا الْإِيمَانُ وَلَكِنْ جَعَلْنَاهُ نُورًا نَهْدِي بِهِ مَنْ نَشَاءُ مِنْ عِبَادِنَا وَإِنَّكَ لَتَهْدِي إِلَى صِرَاطٍ مُسْتَقِيمٍ. So Allah refers to the, what does he refer to the Quran as? Ruh, life. And a lot of the people that call you because they're suicidal is because the heart is dead. And once the heart dies, the person doesn't want to live again. They no longer want to live. Huh? The person doesn't want to live again. It doesn't want to live. Because the heart has reached that point. So it's very important. Allah said to the Prophet, what did Allah say? وَإِنَّهُ لَتَنْزِيلُ رَبِّ الْعَالَمِينَ نَزَلَ بِهِ الرُّوحُ الْأَمِينَ. Nabiullah Jibreel came down with it, the Quran. So Jibreel was referred to as Ruh, because what he's carrying is something that's given life to the people. The second benefit in the remembrance of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, it is when the person remembers Allah, they have placed a fortress between them and shaytan. In other words, the person gets control over their own affairs. وَلِذَٰلِكَ, the book that many people have in their pockets today, in which they read, what is it called? Fortress of a Muslim. Fortress. That's why it's called a fortress of a Muslim. The reason it's called a fortress of a Muslim is because it places between the person and shaytan a hisnun hasin, a very strong fortress in which shaytan can't come to them. And this is taken from a hadith that Imam Ahmad narrated in his Musnad, and other than him, with a chain which is authentic, that the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, he said, "Inna Allah azza wa jalla amara," that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, he commanded Yahya ibn Zakariya. Allah commanded Yahya ibn Zakariya, the Prophet, bi khamsi kalimat, in five statements, five things, and ya'mala bihinna, that he implements it first. And this is the first thing. When somebody learns something, who's the first person who has to implement it? Him. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, he says to Yahya ibn Zakariya, first of all, you implement it. An ya'mala bihinna. Wa an ya'mura bani Israel, and that he commands what? Bani Israel to what? He calls Bani Israel to it. وَلِذَلِكَ وَفْدُ Abdul Qais, when they came to the Prophet, do you guys know the delegation of Abdul Qais that came to the Prophet? The Wafd Abdul Qais, when they came to the Prophet alayhi salatu wasalam, they said, "Ya Rasulullah, we can't keep coming to you, because between you and us there's an enemy, and the only time that they stop fighting with us is the Ashhurul Hurum, the sacred months. That's the only time that we can come. Other than that, we're in battle with these people. So we can't come through, they'll kill us. So when we come to you, teach us something that we can implement, and we can what? We can convey it to those who are behind us." So look first, who do they want it for? Themselves. And then they wanted it for? That's why the scholars, they say that the intention of seeking knowledge and the intention of gaining knowledge is فَلْتَقْصِدُ أَرْبَعَةً قَبْلَ ابْتِدَاءً. فَلْتَقْصِدُ أَرْبَعَةً قَبْلَ ابْتِدَاءً. Intend four things before you start seeking knowledge. The first one is it. What was it? أولها الخروج من ضلال وثاني نفع خلق للجلال وثالث الإحياء للعلوم والرابع العمل للمعلوم. The first is for you to leave the realm of ignorance. That's the first reason why you're learning for. So these companions, this is what it was for them and the believers. So he said, خمس كلمات أن يعمل بهن, that he implemented, وأن يأمر بني إسرائيل أن يعملوا بهن, and that he caused بني إسرائيل to implement these five things. And the five things, the first one of them was what? At-Tawheed. The first of it was At-Tawheed. And then it was Salah. And then it was what? Sadaqah. And then it was the remembrance of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And he said, وَأَمُرُكُمْ بِذِكْرِ اللَّهِ عَزَّ وَجَلَّ, I command you the remembrance of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. وَإِنَّ مَثَلَ ذَلِكَ, the example of this, the one who remembers Allah, is كَمَثَلِ رَجُلٍ, it's like a man. طَلَبَهُ الْعَدُوُ, the army are running after him. He's got enemy after him, trying to catch with him. سِرَاعًا فِي أَثَرِهِ, they are right behind him to catch him. فَأَتَى حِسْنًا حَصِينًا, and then he comes to a fortress and he locks himself in it. Would the enemy be able to attack him now? And then the believer who resorts to dhikr and the remembrance of Allah, that's what he does. He gets away from his enemy like that. ولذلك Allah says in the Quran, قُلْ أَعُوذُ بِرَبِّ النَّاسِ مَلِكِ النَّاسِ إِلَهِ النَّاسِ مِنْ شَرِّ الْوَسْوَاسِ الْخَنَّاسِ. Who knows what is meant by الوسواس للخناس الذي يوسوس is talking about شيطان. Okay, good. But what does it mean, الوسواس للخناس? What does it mean here? He whispers. Who does he whisper to? الغافل عن ذكر الله. The one who is what? Who's heedless of all. The remembrance of who? خناس means what? What the waswas he does to the person who's ghafil. So what does khannas mean that he's doing? Khannas means it turns away and it becomes small and it runs away. Shaytan, when the dhikr of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala comes, khanasa, itasagara, becomes very small. Becomes very small and weak, fragile. That's what the remembrance of Allah does to it, subhanahu wa ta'ala. يعني ابتعد as Ibn al-Qayyim says, it becomes far from the person. ولذلك the Prophet ﷺ has said in a hadith, إذا نودي للصلاة, when the salah, the adhan is made, أدبر الشيطان, the shaytan turns away, وله, and it has a ضراط, which is that it makes noise. It makes a noise, because it doesn't want to hear the remembrance of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. The next benefit that it has is that it brings about tranquility to the heart. The person becomes tranquil. Tranquility comes from the remembrance of Allah. As Allah said in the Quran, أَلَا بِذِكْرِ اللَّهِ تَطْمَئِنُّ الْقُلُوبِ. That in the remembrance of Allah does the heart find tranquility. Allah says in another ayah, الَّذِينَ آمَنُوا وَتَطْمَئِنُّ قُلُوبُهُمْ بِذِكْرِ اللَّهِ أَلَا بِذِكْرِ اللَّهِ تَطْمَئِنُّ الْقُلُوبُ. In the same ayah, the beginning of it. The heart, it becomes calm. The person becomes a state of comfort, tranquility. Some might ask, what does it mean, أَلَا بِذِكْرِ اللَّهِ تَطْمَئِنُّ الْقُلُوبُ. The hadith of Bukhari, Muslim, من حديث سهيب الرومي رضي الله تعالى عنه, that the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم said, عجب لأمر المؤمن إن أمره كله خير. Because the believer, his situation is one of two. إن أصابته صراء شكر فكان خيرا له وإن أصابته ضراء صبر فكان خيرا له وذلك وليس ذلك إلا للمؤمن وليس ذلك إلا للمؤمن. That the person's situation is either good Or it's a situation of hardship and calamity, true or false. The believer remembers Allah in both situations. Ibn Taymiyyah says, the times of hardship, there is a particular demand of servitude that's needed from you. The times of hardship. And the times of good and joyful times, there's a type of servitude that's needed from you. What is it? The first one, shukr. Gratitude, when it's joyful times and you're enjoying yourself now, you got your money, you got your car, you got everything you want, you are remembering Allah through gratitude. Shukr. Sah? And when you're going through hardship, you're remembering Allah through what? Patience. And then, if you're doing those two things and you're coming with both of them, your heart is going to find tranquility. Isn't that the case? Your heart will find tranquility. Because you're one of those two situations. Today you're either enjoying yourself, and tomorrow, agony and pain, you're going through. And each time, you are remembering Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala by what? By coming with what is needed from you. وَلِذَلِكَ الْإِمَامِ عَبْدُ الرَّحْمَنِ نَاصِرُ السَّعْدِيُ رَحِمَهُ اللَّهِ. Some people, they call him a Sa'di, but the correct way of calling him is Sa'di. He summarized the benefits of the benefit of the dhikr in the final lines, and inshallah I'm going to conclude there. He says, فَذِكْرُ إِلَهِ الْعَرْشِ سِرًّا وَمُعْلَنًا يُزِيلُ الشَّقَى وَالْهَمَّ عَنْكَ وَيَطْرُدُ وَيَجْلُبُ لِلْخَيْرَاتِ دُنْيًا وَآجِلًا وَإِنْ يَأْتِكَ الْوَسْوَاسُ يَوْمًا يُشَرِّدُ فَقَدْ أَخْبَرَ الْمُخْتَارُ يَوْمًا لِصَحْبِهِ بِأَنَّ كَثِيرَ الذِّكْرِ فِي السَّبْقِ مُفْرِدُ ووصى معاذا يستعين إلهه على ذكره والشكر بالحسن يعبد وأوصى لشخص قد أتى لنصيحة وقد كان في حمل الشرائع يجهد بأن لا يزل رطب لسانك هذه تعين على كل الأمور وتسعد. And he went on to say, this part where he says, وَأَوْصَى لِشَخْصٍ قَدْ أَتَاهُ, that the Prophet gave an advice to a person who came to him. He's talking about the hadith that we started with. And then he says, وَأَخْبَرَ أَنَّ اللَّهَ يَذْكُرُ عَبْدَهُ وَمَعَهُ عَلَىٰ كُلِّ الْأُمُورِ يُسَدِّدُ وَأَخْبَرَ أَنَّ الذِّكْرَ يَبَقَى بِجَنَّةٍ وَيَنْقَطِعُ التَّكْلِيفُ حِينًا يُخَلَّدُ وَلَوْ لَمْ يَكُنْ فِي ذِكْرِي غَيْرَ أَنَّهُ طَرِيقٌ إِلَى حُبِّ الْإِلَهِ وَمُرْشِدُ وَيَنْهَى الْفَتَى عَنْ غِيبَةٍ وَنَمِيمَةٍ وَعَنْ كُلِّ قَوْلٍ لِلدِّيَانَةِ مُفْسِدُ لَكَانَ لَنَا حَظٌّ عَظِيمٌ وَرَغْبَةٌ بِكَثْرَةِ ذِكْرِ اللَّهِ نِعْمَ الْمُوَحَّدُ وَلَكِنَّنَا مِنْ جَهْلِنَا قَلَّ ذِكْرُنَا كَمَا قَلَّ مِنَّا لِلْإِلَهِ التَّعَبُّدُ وَاللَّهُ أَعْلَمُ صَلَّى اللَّهُ وَسَلَّمَ عَلَى نَبِي سَيِّدِنَا مُحَمَّدْ وَآخِرْ دَعْوَانَا لِلْحَمْدُ لِلَّهِ رَبِّ الْعَالَمِينَ. We'll conclude that بإذن الله. That was just some of the benefits of today's reflection. بارك الله فيكم وجزاكم الله.